Hey guys, it's me, Talia Arisa Gibson. You can call me Tag for short, and welcome to my channel.
Like, comment, subscribe.
I have some Captain D's. I have some fried catfish, okra, hush puppy, mac and cheese, and green beans. And so I also have a strawberry soda, and it might be spiked with a little rum, possibly. but yes, let's say a prayer and then we can get started. Dear God, thank you for this food that I'm about to eat. Thank you for this day. Thank you for Just keeping my viewers safe, happy, and whole. In your name I pray. Amen. Amen. So it is Vlogmas day 10. Day 10. And so this is more of a blog, a mukmas or a vlog bang or a Vlogmas bang. but yeah. Okay, so I also have some sweet and sour sauce I want to try, and then some tartar sauce. So, and then I just have some Texas Pete. Last weekend when I went to the grocery store, someone had bought all of the Louisiana hot sauce. So I just got the Texas Pete, but I have to get the Louisiana hot sauce. That's interesting. It's a different color for a sweet and sour sauce. Usually sweet and sour sauces are like a reddish color. And then here's the tartar sauce. All right, I'm gonna get into some of these green beans. It's a bite for you. They're seasoned well. Let's try the mac and cheese. Yummy. It's okay. I mean, it's definitely not like homemade, but I have some fried okra. Pretty good. Let's try this catfish. You can see it here. I'm gonna try this sweet and sour sauce. It almost tastes like sweet and sour honey mustard. that's a little strange to me, but I mean, it doesn't taste bad. It's just, it literally to me tastes like sweet and sour honey mustard. I wonder, I have to read the ingredients. Let's get one of these hush puppies. The tartar sauce is good. Let's see what the direction says on this. Or the, not directions, the ingredients. Pineapple prepared mustard. Pineapple, prepared mustard. I knew I tasted mustard. Mustard seed as well, turmeric. I knew it, I could taste mustard. All right, I'm gonna get some of this Texas Pete on here. Gotta have that hot sauce. So, I couldn't figure out what I wanted to eat. And so, I wanted to stop somewhere that would be on my way from work to home because it had started kind of raining. And so, I didn't want to kind of go out of my way. And then I saw Captain D's. And so I was like, I haven't eaten there in a long time. Let me go get something from there. So that's what I did. And of course, I prefer like homemade, but they used cornmeal and I think probably a mix of cornmeal and flour. Well, how are y'all doing? How was your week? My week was good. It was busy. It was, you know, working. It's been fun shooting the Vlogmas videos. Just seeing really if I can do a video every day has been interesting for me. So far, so good. So, I wanted to talk a little bit about condolences for Nick Cannon and I don't know if you guys watched or saw in the news, but he lost his baby very recently, just not long ago, his youngest baby. And the baby was only a few months old, like 4 or 5 months old. His name was Zen, and or his name is Zen, but he passed away after being diagnosed with cancer in the brain. I was watching Nick Cannon actually told his told everybody live on his talk show. He told everyone what happened, and it just seemed like it progressed so quickly. They noticed that his son had a fairly large head, but they thought, he said it was kind of normal for his kids to have large heads as babies and stuff, and so they didn't think anything of it. And then they started having issues and finding out that he had a malignant tumor in his brain, and I think they did some surgical procedures, and tried to like see what they could do, but it got to a point where it was just like they knew it was a matter of time. And so he got to spend Thanksgiving with his baby, and got some time to take the baby by the water and just spend some quality time as a father and son with the baby. And
Nick Cannon's youngest son has died from brain cancer. The actor announced the news of 5-month-old Zen's death on his daytime show, Nick Cannon. He started by explaining that when the baby was 2 months old, he and Zen's mother, Alyssa Scott, had taken him to a doctor after they noticed his head had seemed large. Doctors discovered a malignant tumor and performed surgery. Cannon went on to share that he and Scott were faithful and hopeful for their son, adding that he had embraced every moment. He also commended Scott, calling her the strongest woman I've ever seen. He then revealed that around Thanksgiving, Zen's health took a turn for the worse as the tumor began to grow a lot faster. He shared that he had managed to spend some quality time with Zen over this past weekend. He and Scott took him to the ocean in Los Angeles.
I wanted to make sure that, you know, I had allowed the sun to rise and, you know, kind of hold my son. And in the having the last, holding my son for the last time. But it was a beautiful setting.
Cannon went on to say that even while holding Zen at the beach, he was planning to return to New York for work, but he ended up turning around. So, while he not only got to see the sunrise with his son, he also got to see the sunset too. Cannon also shared that while he didn't know how he was going to be while on his show, he wanted to grieve with his family. He added that he was dedicating the show to his beautiful son, Zen.
Prayers to him, the mother of the baby. I know it has to be very difficult for the mother, because you carry a child that closely for 9 months as a part of your body, and to only have a few months where the baby is actually able to be in your arms outside of your body, just for the baby to go back and transition on away from you again, like that has to be devastating. I mean, the baby had no time to live and develop into who he could have been, just to be able to learn to talk and learn to walk and go to school for the first time and say his first word. The baby had no time to live and develop into who he could have been, just to be able to learn to talk and learn to walk and go to school for the first time and say his first words. Like, you never get any of that. It's just sad. I don't know. It's like watching him tell everyone, tell the world what happened to his son. I mean, seeing him get so teary-eyed and just trying to make it through telling everyone about it. It was just really devastating. Moments like that, you really understand just how short life can be. Like, the baby just didn't get time on earth. Just, and it sometimes, I don't know about you guys, but when stuff like that happens, I just wonder, like, why? What's the purpose? What's the purpose, like, for a family to be excited about the birth of a baby and then the baby to arrive and the excitement of the baby being born just to be taken from you? It's just, I don't understand it. And I can imagine as parents, they surely probably don't understand it. But I know Nick expressed like his faith in God and that he knows he'll get through it. As hard as it is right now and the grief that he feels, he said he knows that he'll get through it. And I'm sure the kids are devastated because he has other kids. And
where I've seen so much love, y'all. More love than I probably ever experienced. So even in the midst of a loss, I gotta say thank you to y'all. Y'all ready for the pick of the day? Yeah. All right, let's do it. Bam. Now, you're looking at that, and it probably looks like a really interesting picture, but let me explain to you, that's actually my rib right there. Last night, I got the opportunity to go get a tattoo of my son, Zen, as an angel on my rib.
It's sad because, you know, it was kind of like a running joke of, like, if you want to have a baby, then you should date Nick because he's very fertile. Because I think he had two women that were pregnant at once, not far apart at all. And so he has another baby that's a little bit older than the one that just passed away. So, and I believe was there another one or another set of twins? I can't remember exactly, but there was a lot of talk about all of that. And but you don't want anybody to go through a devastating loss like that. It's crazy. Guys, have demolished this plate because I didn't eat lunch. The secretary at my job, it was her birthday. Tomorrow's her birthday, or Sunday, one of them. And we had some cake and fruit and just a few snacks, like cake, fruit, and like cheese. I think that was it. But after eating some of the fruit and the cake and the cheese, I didn't really want my lunch. And so I was like, why am I so hungry? But that's why. Because that was more like a snack. And that wasn't like that was at like 11:30, somewhere around there. So that's why I inhaled that, because I did not eat lunch. So that was like my lunch and dinner. But yeah, definitely keeping Nick and his family in my prayers. I hate to hear that his baby passed away and only got to be here for such a short time. And I know that Nick and his and the baby's mother cherish the moments that they did have with the baby. I know that they don't have any regrets. I know that they're happy that they were able to meet Zen. But I just hate that they didn't get more time with the baby to just live and see what he grew up into. And it's just those things in life where you just don't understand, like when babies die, just even sometimes babies being like stillborn. It's like, why? Like, just for a mother to carry a baby for so long and the baby to just not make it. And I don't know. I just hated to hear about that. I was going to talk about the Jussie Smollett verdict, but then I heard about that and I was just like, let me just talk about that a little bit. You know, the times that we're in, the holidays, like, it's a joy just spending holidays with children. And they bring out just like the holiday spirit of, you know, just being kids and not knowing just how messed up the world is and all the things that adults have to worry about. Like, kids, they just help bring out the joy. Even babies, just being new to the world and just enjoying like their mother and their father and just being taken care of. So I know that this is going to be a difficult holiday for them. I mean, for that to happen right after Thanksgiving and then going into the holidays with Christmas coming up and the new year. And it's just, I don't know. I just hate to see people lose people. I know I've lost loved ones, losing my sister when I was 17, she was 19. Like, those kind of devastating losses, they make a big impact on you. And I mean, I've lost other loved ones along the way, but some just really hit you really, really hard. And I don't know the loss of a child. My mother does, of course, because she lost my sister and that was her child. And I just think parents never expect to have their children leave this earth before they do. They want their kids to grow up and have a long life, and they want to be the ones who go before their children. And so I know that that's hard, but I'll just keep them in my thoughts and prayers. I hope you all do the same. I think sometimes we forget that celebrities, like I said, are just human beings too. And life happens, whether you are a millionaire and you're famous, whether you are just someone who lives in your local community and maybe nobody else in the world knows who you are, but life still happens to you just like it will for anybody else. And so fame and money, none of that stops life from happening. And so real things like illness and death, all those things still exist and will affect you regardless of your life. And so, yeah, I don't know. I just, sorry for the Debbie Downer video, but I just felt really bad, like, just watching him try to talk and tell the world that he lost his baby. And then, of course, they were showing pictures of the baby, and it's just like, why? Like, why didn't the baby have a chance at life? And it's nothing you could do, like, nothing they could have done to keep that baby here. And it's like, I'm sure if they could have done anything, like, they would have done anything to keep the baby alive. And it's like those kinds of things, like cancer and things like that, they just ravage the body. Like, it just took over the little baby's brain. And I mean, you're that little and trying to fight something that's just a beast. I don't know, it's just really, really sad. This was more of a mukbang, of course, but it's a daily video, and so it's my Vlogmas mukbang. But I appreciate you guys for tuning in. Cherish your loved ones, cherish your life. When you look in the mirror, don't just see all your problems and all the things that you're going through. See that, oh wow, I'm alive, there's a purpose for my life. What can I do today that will make me smile? What can I do today that will make someone else smile? But just remember, you're here for a reason and you're special. And it can be the lowest of the low of days, but it can also always be worse. And so I appreciate you all. I hope you are staying in good spirits. Hang in there. Don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe, and always, always, always hit that bell notification so you'll know when I post. Until next time.